the street talking other stuff, Mike. Mad Dog Magnotti. Thanks for tuning in on this great Monday. Hey, the weather. This is great. March, you know, my grandson works, has been working for the Tree Fruit Research Center. He's been coming home with a sunburn. Now, where else can that happen in this country? This is great. It's beautiful. Sunburned in March. It's cool. But hey, thanks for tuning in today. I got a good show for you. But just a couple of things. My wife and I were taking a walk the other day, and we saw this thing nailed to a telephone pole, and I went over and looked at it. It was a Justin Bieber concert ticket nailed to this telephone pole, so I took it, because you never know when you're going to need a nail, right? Oh, and you know, I know. All right, okay. And if the word pros is the opposite of the word cons, does that mean Congress is the opposite of the word progress? You know, that would be funnier if it wasn't so possibly true. And did you hear about the Sylvester Stallone movie marathon that was gonna start up pretty much? People have been saying it's been getting off to a rocky start. Okay, all right, sorry, but hey, all right, fine. It's nice to be back. In all honesty, if you've been watching the show, the last 3 weeks were taped. They weren't live because I had hip replacement surgery, and now I was on a walker. Now I'm on a cane, so I'm actually live today. So thanks for tuning in. I appreciate it. But look, I got a great show for you today. We're going to take a great break. Take a quick break. I have a very interesting guest you're going to be thrilled to meet. But hey, stick around. Street Talk and other stuff. We will be right back.
Nissan is the value leader in new cars and SUVs. Check out these new models starting at under $20,000. The all-new Versa from $17,020. The all-new Sentra from $17,400. And the all-new Kicks from $17,995. Now you can have the Nissan style, performance, and reliability all for under $20,000.
And they're all here at Town Nissan, up behind Costco in East Wenatchee.
Why run all over town when you can get the financial services you need under one roof? The location is 521 Chelan Street, right here in Wenatchee. Accounting solutions for success. Insurance from trusted choices. Real estate, the power of the edge. Personal, professional, preferable. It's all right here. Get the edge on your financial needs. Now available in Chelan as well. Get more information at augustedge.com.
Hi, this is Brian Snyder with BlackRock Asphalt Services here in Wenatchee, your local BlackRock Seal Coat company. Have you looked at your driveway or parking lot lately? Is it gray and oxidized? Does it have cracks that have not been taken care of? Or do you have striping that is pretty much non-existent? Please give us a call locally here, 509-665-9769. Learn more at BlackRockAsphaltSealCoating.com.
I'm Dr. Wayne Latimer. I'm a chiropractic physician. I have postgraduate certifications in both whiplash, trauma, and rehab, as well as sports medicine. The location is great. The light and the visibility, the 17-foot ceilings are fantastic. You can go into a lot of clinics, and it's very clinical. People really like the spa environment, so my whole premise was take a spa environment, add the very serious rehab, and give people an enjoyable way to get better over time.
Talking other stuff, and I am very happy to introduce to you Ms. Laura Merrill. She is the Executive Services Director for the City of Wenatchee. And when I do this, that means let's shake hands.
Oh, sorry.
I don't have the coronavirus, I promise.
Okay. I thought you were doing this. So,
but, you know, when I found out that Ms. Merrill had been hired for the position that opened up a little while ago, I really wanted to get her on the show, contacted her, we worked it out. Here she is. Yeah, so thanks very much for being here.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
So, well, look, tell us a little bit about yourself, you know, so people get to know you a little bit so they know that, you know, they say, wow, this is really a cool lady.
Oh, I hope so. Yeah. So I am from Fresno, California. Okay. I was the deputy city manager there for the city of Fresno, which is a city of over 500,000 people.
Oh,
so
big place.
Big place. worked there for about 5 years in different positions, but again, most recently as deputy city manager. But I have family up here over the hill, so Washington's really been a place that I've wanted to be for a long time.
Now, were you, I mean, did you live in Fresno where you came from and not just work there?
No, I've been in Fresno for about 10 years off and on. So I lived in San Jose in the Bay Area. I was originally born in Mexico, but my parents brought me here early on and kind of went all over the place, mostly in Fresno, though. Sacramento for a little bit. I even worked in Linwood for a while here in Washington. So that's my longest place that I've been at, and then at that career, too, with the city of Fresno. But I went to college there as well, so my background is I have a Bachelor's of Science in Business Administration with an option in marketing. I have, let's see, 3 siblings. So I have an older brother and a younger brother and a younger sister. My parents are here in Washington. My sister's in San Diego. My husband, Adam, and then we have 3 dogs, 3 big dogs.
Yeah, she said her dogs all weigh about 60 pounds.
Yeah, so we have 2 huskies and a border collie. So I'm constantly covered in hair.
Yeah, I'll bet. Yeah. So, I mean, look, you must have...
I do the roller. Yeah, okay, cool. I do the roller when I get to work. So
we won't look at her back. See if she missed any parts there.
So. Yeah. And that's kind of, you know, in a snapshot, my professional and family background. Mm-hmm. But other than that, you know, I love hiking and running and being outdoors.
Good place for that. Yeah.
Great place for
this. Do you ski or anything like that?
I don't. I tried snowboarding for some time, but you know, I say you can't be an average snowboarder because otherwise it's really painful. You have to be good.
I mean, I wouldn't know because my sport is laying on the couch reading books.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, a friend of mine, they were in church yesterday. They're avid skiers all their lives. You know?
Sure.
She really seriously hurt her shoulder. And I said to her, you know, if you lay on your couch and read books, things like that doesn't happen.
Right. Yeah, it's a fun sport. You know, it looks
I'll take your word for it. I don't equate cold and fun.
Sure.
So.
But you guys get a lot of really great sun out here. So yeah, I bet you it's beautiful in Mission Ridge.
Well, you'll love summer. You know? You know, it's dry here. I don't know what Fresno's climate's like. But this is basically
dry.
A desert.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know, so get some, you know, we get to triple digits heat sometimes. Yep. Well, you'll experience that.
Yeah, I'm not a stranger to that at all. Oh, you know, cool. 115 plus weeks in July and August is probably the worst months. We were fortunate enough not to have to deal with fires as much as you have here in Wenatchee.
Yeah, and that's been interesting because when I first moved out here in 73, it didn't seem to be that much of an issue. It just seems to be over the last... you know, dozen, 20 years or so that the,
But otherwise, you know, I'm enjoying the weather here either way, the bit of snow and beautiful views and the beautiful air.
Oh yeah, it's great.
It's awesome.
Okay, so what was your job down in Fresno again?
I was the deputy city manager.
And what did that involve?
So it was very high level project management. And so there we had a strong mayor form of government, but because of the scope of the city, we also had a city manager, 2 assistant city managers, and then myself. And so I kind of did whatever fell on my plate, you know, and so it was everything from restructuring our special events process to applying for grants, working through major housing projects, working with all of our departments to do interdepartmental projects and coordination. A little bit of everything, really.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
All right, so you moved up here, you said, because your hubby was the one who...
Mm-hmm. Yep, okay. Yep. So he got a job in Quincy, and I left my job in California.
Right.
And I was kind of just sort of going to hang around and, you know, see my new environment. And, you know, I joked around about going to Italy or doing something crazy, right? But really, I just...
Going to Italy is not crazy, you know? Go on.
No, that's okay.
I sometimes forget that my guest should be talking about herself, and I like to say the show's really about me. But go ahead. I'm sorry.
So I was just going to take some time off, basically, during the holidays. So I was off for about 3 months. Got a chance to move into our house and really get everything settled, which was really nice to... when you're moving across different state lines and having to drive everything up and... the coordination with our house back in Fresno. So it was really nice to be able to have a good stretch of time to relax and move in.
All right, so what happened? Mm-hmm. You know, what ended this period of, I don't know, ennui, should we say, you know, that all of a sudden you're right back in the thick of things.
I was. So I'd been keeping an eye out for sort of opportunities here in the city, and I'd been kind of following different agencies and organizations to try to get myself acclimated with all of the different organizations and sort of politics of Wenatchee and outlying areas. And I saw that there was an opening for the Moses Lake City Manager job. And so I kind of was tracking that to see, okay, you know, that's a big deal. That's a nearby city. How would that impact the rest of the different areas? And got to learn about Allison Williams, who formerly held this position, through that way. I reached out to her on LinkedIn, and, you know, she connected me with the mayor, who literally knocked on my door and said,
Mayor Frank, right?
Yes. and said, hey, you know, are you still interested in working in the public sector? We'd love to chat with you. So after that, we did a series of different interviews with all of his directors and some of his council members. Really got to meet all of the team and make sure that it was a good fit for everybody.
Yeah. And you obviously were comfortable with all this. You liked what you saw.
And I was absolutely excited about the opportunity. I didn't think that something like this would come up so quickly or so easily accessible for me, right? A lot of times these positions are kind of already done, right? Internal positions, internal promotions and whatnot. And so to be given the opportunity as someone from outside of the area who doesn't know anyone was quite the opportunity for me. So I was very excited.
All right, so you technically, Frank Kuntz, the mayor, is your boss, right?
Yes.
Okay, now just between you and me, I promise I won't tell him. Now, I like him, you know, but what do you think of him, you know? I mean, really, what's he like?
I think he's great.
You do?
Yeah.
But don't worry, I mean, nobody, he's not watching, you know? just between you and I, really, he's a good boss?
He's a great boss.
Really? Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, he's real easygoing, very energetic.
Yeah.
But he's, you know, with all of the amount of information and everything that's going on in the departments, he gets it. You know, he gets the details. He's in the weeds. But he's also really, he's not a micromanager. He really allows.
Oh, great. Good. Because I would hate that myself.
Yeah. He really allows all of his team to sort of have that autonomy to be able to run their departments and make those decisions. So he's really been great to work with.
No, frankly, I do think he's a great mayor. I mean, when he first got elected, I can't remember the exact details of the problem, but Wenatchee was going through some struggling stuff at the time, and I really thought he was the man for the job. A matter of fact, a local politician, when Frank first ran, another guy who was high up in the Democrat side kind of waylaid me, actually a former mayor of Wenatchee, waylaid me and said, well, we really have a great person running for mayor in the form of, and mentioned who Frank's opponent was. And I just looked at him and said, I don't know, Frank's going to be hard to beat. And he got all insulted and stormed away, you know. I think Frank does a great job.
Yeah. So, and it's been consistent from what I can tell in the past years as he's been mayor. And so.
No, he's been the person we needed, like I said, when he first was elected.
Yeah.
So, and I can say it because I'm not running for anything. I'm not going to look for a job. So.
We don't know.
No. I work for myself now. And that's hard to beat. Matter of fact, I told somebody the other day that I have issues with how I dress because I said, working for myself, I'm constantly casual Friday.
Sure. That's nice.
So good. Yeah. But you're liking it here.
Yeah, I love it.
And Wenatchee, overall, I mean, how do you feel about this particular city and this area? So,
you know, it's such a great little hidden gem. It really is.
We
didn't know anything about Wenatchee when we first moved here. It was just sort of a, all right, we're going to Quincy, right? Where should we live? And so finding this here has been incredible to know that, hey, we're going to be, you know, we want to be here long term. Yeah. We want to have some roots here. And so to be in such a fantastic community. And I think one of the things that's really stood out for me from everyone that I've talked to, and even just the first couple of days that I was here, your downtown is so cute and says just the, the best little shops.
Yeah.
And coming from a public sector background, I know how difficult that is to implement. And I know the amount of resources and things that need to happen to get those things in motion. So seeing all of the waterfront development, seeing all of the different events, the Apple Blossom event, I'm super super excited to attend that for my first time. So.
Right, and I did. I leaned on her. I told her she needs to come see Mamma Mia.
yes. So. I need to do that. That's on my list now, too. But so much to do, and all in such a great, beautiful place.
Yeah. Okay. We are talking with Ms. Laura Merrill. She is the Executive Services Director for the City of Wenatchee. We're going to talk more specifically about what her current role is and what her duties are now. But we're going to take a quick break. But street talking other stuff. Mike, Mad Dog Magnotti, you stick around. We will be right back.
With TV advertising, what we want to do is more deeply connect with the community.
People spot me in different parts around North Central, Costco and Wenatchee, say, hey, you're the pizza guy. And so they wouldn't know that if it weren't for the TV commercials we've done.
We've been here so long and people already know who we are and what we do, but to have that image flash on their television screen as opposed to just hearing in the radio or seeing in the newspaper. I just love the fact that we can actually put our finger on when a customer comes in and says, I saw your ad.
It's becoming increasingly difficult in this digital age to know where are your customers listening or watching, because I watch all the different channels that they watch too, like Cooking Channel, History Channel, and so it was wonderful to be able to be on there.
I would say that if you want to do business in Wenatchee, then you should connect with the people of Wenatchee, and there's no better way to do that than with NCWLIFE.
Did you know that nearly 50% of pet poisoning cases involve human medications and prescription drugs? Sometimes the culprit's a curious dog, but cats get into their share of trouble as well. Other times, pet owners mistakenly give their pets their own medications that are safe to people, but toxic to their pets. Dr. Shauna Bayes and her staff care about your pets. Go to pawsandclawsvh.com for a complete list of medications to avoid or call 888-PAWS.
Motion e-bikes have rolled into Wenatchee. We've got fun, affordable e-bikes for the whole family. Portable e-bikes that fit right in the trunk of your car. Fat tire mountain bikes plus unique vintage style bikes you won't find anywhere else. Get some exercise with pedal assist or just cruise up to 20 miles per hour with the throttle. Starting under $1,000, Green Motion e-bikes are affordable fun for the whole family. Green Motion e-bikes is located right downtown on the corner of Palouse and Wenatchee Avenue.
My guest today is Laura Merrill. She is the Executive Services Director for the City of Wenatchee, and you've been on the job since, I think, November?
I started interviewing in November. Okay. I officially started February 3rd, I believe.
Okay,
yeah, about a month.
All right. Mm-hmm. So what do you do? I mean, what does Executive Services Director mean? What is what's your job title? And I know what the title is. What's your job description?
The job description is a little bit of everything. Mm-hmm. It's really lots of different hats, but I would say it's mostly, they've described it as sort of a chief of staff to the mayor. Okay. I'm sort of his eyes and ears when he can't be there, and I make sure that anything that he needs to know gets back to him, sort of that communication piece between the department directors and him.
Okay.
But then also just keeping oversight over some high level executive projects, and so if it's something that the mayor really wants to focus on, whether it's a certain contract or a certain lease, that's something that falls within my plate to be involved in, to ensure that it's moving along as it needs to be. I know that's very high level, or seems very high level, but with so many different departments and so many things going on at one time, it's that keeping track of all the little puzzle pieces.
Okay, all right. Mm-hmm. So any particular projects going on now that are interesting that you can talk about?
Confluence Parkway.
Make something up.
Confluence Parkway is probably the biggest one.
Okay.
We submitted the infra grant for that.
And that's the new possible second bridge across the Wenatchee River going out of town on the north end, right?
Right. So across the north end of town, and it's a pretty big project to help alleviate some of the congestion on North Wenatchee Wenatchee Avenue. It involves an underpass and certain areas, and then sort of readjusting the Apple Loop Trail so that it's kind of further away from the railroad tracks and the new street to really make sure that both uses have the best possible scenario for pedestrian and then also vehicle traffic. Right. So I just attended a meeting last week on that, a public meeting, kind of answer any questions, let the public know where we're up to date on that. So that's something that I'm, you know, watching for the mayor, and if he needs me to kind of ask staff about any certain questions or anything he needs to be queued up about, I make sure that I have that information ready for him. Okay. So that's probably the biggest project right now
I
would say.
And that's one that's gonna need federal money, right?
Yes.
Now, is that something, I mean, who writes the grants for that? I mean, how does that process work that we go to the feds and say, hey, we need, what is it, $242 million?
I think it's 170, I might be wrong, don't quote me on that one.
No, that's all right. I think maybe the 242 is the total amount or something.
But there may be, because there's also lots of other funds that we're gonna be requesting from the state, and so all of the matching funds, as they call them, to make sure that we get every little piece covered and all of the extra amenities or goodies, as you might call them. Typically in a grant package, you submit for a main project, but you try to do things that are, that align well with it as well.
Sure.
And so the package also includes a new pedestrian street bridge, connecting the current street bridge on Bridge Street.
Mm-hmm.
So things like that, that really help again with the circulation of pedestrian traffic and access.
Okay.
But to answer your question, Steve King, our economic development director, and his team, as well as some of our public works team, put together that grant. And that was submitted last month. Mm-hmm. So now we're kind of just
waiting. This is the grant of the feds, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. So now we're just in a holding pattern. They are working on the environmental work and trying to get that done in the meanwhile, but the grant's in. We're just hoping to get a good call or, you know, good outcome sometime in September.
Okay. Now, let's say that is granted. What's the time frame for that project to be completed, you know? I mean, I may be going beyond what you know.
I believe, you know, there's all of the sort of implementation, pre-implementation. So it's signing the grant, doing all of the environmental work, and then you have 2 or 3 years to finish the project. So I would say if we get awarded in September, a 5-year scope.
Oh, okay.
Right? Okay. Which is...
I might live to see it.
You pretty, you will. It's quicker because that money is tied to, you know, grant projects. They want you to get moving. They want you to show that you're ready. And that's a big piece of all of the work that the city team has done to get to the point of applying, all of the cost estimates, all of the studies, all of the engineering work. And so we'd be pretty ready to implement once that money comes in.
Now, just from listening to you talk about it, it seemed, I mean, you enjoy this type of thing, evidently.
I do, I don't know how I ended up in this world, but it's really, you know, if you would have asked me when I was young, I
was gonna say, what you want to be when you were a little girl?
I wanted to be a marine biologist.
Oh, really? Oh, okay.
Yeah, and then I found out I was scared of the ocean, right? So.
That's not gonna work.
No. I love animals still. Yeah. I still have a huge heart for animals.
Yeah, you've got three dogs that weigh 60 pounds.
I do. You know, I think it works. I retain a lot of information very quickly. I can connect those puzzle pieces. It's a very specific job, I think, that maybe not a lot of people would be happy with, or it can be very stressful.
Yeah.
But I think I'm a problem solver, right? And so to me, it's not something that's stressful and I don't know how to deal with it. This is a problem. Hmm. Okay, how do we solve it? And it's that stuff is interesting to me.
Oh, cool.
So,
good. You seem like you have the right temperament for it then.
Yeah, I do enjoy it.
Okay, so you do kind of work with all city departments?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so, how are you and Stevie Crown getting along?
Good, great.
Really? Okay.
The chief is awesome. He's been...
He is a great guy.
Yes.
When he started working, I'd like to brag about this, when he started working for the PD, he was on my shift.
Okay.
So, and I loved him. As a matter of fact, when Steve quit to go to Fish and Wildlife or whatever he went to, I was really bummed out. I was going through a really rough period, you know, cop burnout and that kind of stuff. And I, when Steve quit, but I was really, really happy when he came back. I think he's a really good cop.
He's a great guy. He's one of the directors that I kind of had lunch with and sat down with prior to my starting. And you know, he's very much about quality in his police force and making sure that we've got the right people out there, training, giving them the right resources. And so I think he and again, we sat down a couple weeks ago, and he's very approachable and, very intelligent person.
Yeah, bright guy. Mm-hmm. Very bright guy.
So far, I mean, he's been fantastic.
And he was fun to work with because he's so doggone big. It was always great when Steve was backing you up because, you know, nobody ever gave him.
He's tall, yeah.
He's tall, he's big. Matter of fact, when I first met him, I was in detectives. It was back in the 90s. And I had a call out for actually a murder, you know, and I'm in the squad room like 2 o'clock in the morning, and all of a sudden Captain Bowles walks in with this biggest guy I've ever seen. Oh, who is this guy? You know? But yeah, he'd been hired and was just coming to ride along to see how things were going. But no, he's a great guy.
Great guy.
So other city departments, you know, how are you getting along with the other city heads and that kind of stuff?
Sure. So great. Also, you know, I've been doing sort of one-on-ones with all of the departments to sit down and understand, what are their priorities? Yeah. What are their goals? How can I help them get there? You know, I feel like that's part of my job is sort of helping that cohesiveness of all of our city departments to make sure that one department isn't doing one thing absent another department. And so they've, you know, opened their doors, welcomed me in, got to meet all of their teams. I actually get to do the tour of the wastewater treatment plant today.
Oh, really? Wow.
Yeah.
Ooh, what
meet
a
all
thrill.
The staff. I know. That might not be exciting
so
for
exciting.
You. I think it's exciting. A couple weeks ago we did the regional water plant, and just to see the immense amount of machinery and everything it takes to run something so that we can have clean water, it's pretty exciting.
Well, I would say she's the right gal for the job, you know? Pretty exciting, huh?
I do, yeah.
Just when you said you were going to go to the waste treatment plant, your face just lit up as if, boy, it's like I'm going to Disneyland.
Sort of Disneyland. Yeah.
No, that's good. All right, have there been any challenges you haven't expected? Anything kind of blindside you with this job that, you know?
You know, I would say that it's interesting that Wenatchee is a smaller community than what I'm used to, but there are so many agencies. Yeah. And I think that's been challenging to me to try to get my head around. In Fresno, it was a much larger city, but all of the different agencies sort of had their role, right? Mm-hmm. And here it seems like a lot of the agencies are overlapping. But having been meeting with all of the different agencies, I can also see that they work well together, or at least they're trying to or attempting to, so there aren't redundancies, and so that we can all work to, you know, get to everyone's goal. And so that's been kind of interesting for me because I was used to sort of playing in a certain lane with just the city of Fresno. And so this is a little bit different in how that's done here. But, you know, it's part of learning the environment and figuring that out.
Well, cool, great.
Yeah.
Okay, we're talking with Ms. Laura Merrill. She's the Executive Services Director for the City of Wenatchee. She's been on board since early February. We got to take a quick break, but we're going to come back, say goodbye to her. But hey, streets are going to stuff. Mike, Mad Dog Magnotti, you stick around. We will be right back. So.
Coming home should never be a chore. Let Merry Maids of Wenatchee customize all your cleaning needs. Weekly, bi-weekly, special occasion. Do you have a vacation home that needs cleaning? We clean them too. Locally owned and operated, let Merry Maids do the cleaning while you focus on your family and friends. Merry Maids has special offers to fit your budget. Request your free cleaning estimate today. 509-663-1710.
I'm Lisa Bradshaw, host of Life with Lisa Bradshaw. I just want to thank all of our viewers for tuning in and watching the show. I leave on the next Don't Wait Project tour in March, and in the meantime, we have plenty of local interviews for your viewing pleasure. Thanks again for watching Life with Lisa Bradshaw. It's not about my life, it's about yours. For more information about showtimes or about the show, visit NCWLIFE.com.
We're talking with Ms. Laura Merrill. She is the Executive Services Director for the City of Wenatchee, and I thank you very much for coming
thank
on.
Thank you so much.
We wish you the best of luck. We're glad to have you. Welcome
thank
to Wenatchee.
Thank you so much.
So, hey. Okay, so street talk and other stuff. Mike, Mad Dog, Magnotti, thanks for being here. We will see you next week. So you have a great day. Have a great week. Bye-bye.
I'm Sue Kane with the Apple STEM Network, and you're watching the NCWLIFE channel.
Get the fastest internet available in North Central Washington by switching to Localtel and get speeds up to 1,000 meg. Call 888-8888 today or go online to localtel.net.